This week on Rugged Expeditions, the team is going to not always so sunny and warm Mexico to try and finish off my quest to collect all the turkeys from around the whole wide world.
Brought to you by Explorer Satellite. Communicate everywhere.
The Chihuahua Desert is its own specific environment. You got dry weather, thorny brush, brown hills, and not a lot of water. There's a reason why they call it desert. As we came out of the airport, the outfitter was waiting for us and picked us up in a camo Suburban that looked like it might need a little bit of redecorating. Yeah.
I think these guys need another sticker.
Yeah, they got. I think he needs it.
Let's do it while he's not looking, though. We don't want to get close.
Right, I think right
here.
You want me to clean it off?
Yeah, get a little.
There you go. There you go, Rugged X.
Now we're
official. You're official. Yeah. Now you're official, Rugged X.
My old hunting buddy Dennis Anderson and I have returned to the Chihuahua Desert to do something different. We're here to hunt the biggest of all the wild turkeys in the world, the Gould's turkey.
The Gould's turkey was named after British ornithologist and artist John Gould, who identified the species in 1856. Native only to the northern mountains of Mexico and a few pockets in southern Arizona and New Mexico, the Goulds are the largest of the five subspecies, with longer legs and feet. Their spurs and beards are typically shorter. Their uniquely colored tail feathers are tipped in white and are substantially different than their cousins. The Goulds are the rarest of all the turkeys and are heavily protected, so hunting them is highly regulated.
Not only are we after the Goulds turkey on this trip, but we're here to hopefully capture on video for the first time a truly wild, free-range Mexican Chihuahua dog right here in its historically natural environment.
Unbeknownst to many, the Chihuahua Desert was once home to the wild and free-range Chihuahua dog. A small, nervous, short-haired mongrel, the Chihuahua is known to have possessive characteristics with aggressive tendencies. Because of this, the small canine usually hunted on their own instead of in packs. Eventually, the people of the area began to domesticate these ferocious little bastards, and now it's become rare to find one scouring these mountains.
After a long trip, it's always good to pull out your goodies and make sure they're all working, maybe tune them up a little bit if they need it. Kind of make sure everything's all in order.
That's a deadly combo right there. I'm feeling pretty good about the old standby.
The food at this ranch house is fantastic. Authentic Mexican food, not American so-called Mexican food, prepared the old-fashioned way. At dawn the next day, we snuck out to a place that looked like it, you know, it might be holding some turkeys. If one spot doesn't work out these mountains, you just gotta keep moving. One thing I've learned about turkey hunting is if they won't come to you, you gotta go to them.
We just gotta keep moving. In this wide open terrain like this, it's important to move, see if you can see them. Try some blind calling, see if you can locate them. It's a big, vast area, and we just didn't hear anything right at dawn that told us they were right here, so I want to be aggressive and keep moving. And just be careful that we don't bump anything, but like that's our only hope.
Thank you.
big open area like this, your only chance is to maybe see some when you're glassing. And if you can get them in an area that you can get to, then you got a chance to get over and get their attention. But with these big distances, it's hard to make a call loud enough that they'll be able to hear you and come this direction. We've got a big cut here between us. It'd be hard to get them to come across anyhow, but that doesn't mean we can't go across it, though, if we see them.
Hey, what the? Tom, what are you doing? Laying down on the job again? Huh? Look, we're a team. We're supposed to be out here hunting and looking for gobblers, okay? And every time I turn around, you're laying down on the job. That's not gonna work for me, okay? I'm hiking around up here in these mountains. I'm carrying your ass around on this mountain. Now, when I'm glassing, pay attention to what's going on, okay?
The property we're hunting in these mountains is huge. It's got very few roads in it, so you better be ready to go for a hike if you're gonna hunt in this spot. If you just ride around the truck all the time, you're not gonna see much. But if you get off your butt and you hike around, you never know what you might find in them there hills.
Wow, will you look at this? I know that there's all kinds of great stuff that grows in Mexico, but I've just discovered the biggest piece of asparagus ever grown on the face of the earth. Look at the size of this thing. I'll bet that'd make your pee smell really funny. One piece would do you for a month. Cool. There's all kinds of things you discover when you're out walking around in the mountains.
Finally, some turkeys came into our water hole. One of them sure looked like he might be a dandy. He just wouldn't break away from the hens and come to me. I called and called, and they were just too far away from me to just whack him while he was down at the water. I thought we might have a better crack at this second bunch of turkeys that showed up just before dark. They got a little closer for a second, but no shot.
This morning, we switched spots in this little blind that we built. We heard some gobbling up on the hill right above us. So the assumption is that they got to come down to water here this morning. Last night we had turkeys come in to this water hole, but they just didn't cooperate where they were dancing around or coming to the decoy. But we know where they walked through, so we're hoping that they do the same thing again. Seen anything this morning, but not some deer, but we want a turkey. And it's not just that I want a turkey for the trophy.
I like eating turkey. I like turkey legs. I like turkey breast. I like turkey bacon, turkey sausage. I like eating turkey a lot. And I'm hungry. And I wish we had a turkey dead so I could eat some turkey.
This morning we're taking Tammy, the turkey decoy, with us. We've given up on Tom. You know, you can only tolerate so much laying around, not doing your job and not performing. So we're breaking out his girlfriend today to see how she does. I think she's gonna do a lot better job.
I got a new shotgun to use. The other guys are done, so since we're using borrowed shotguns, I get to step up to a 3.5 inch, which means that they're probably gonna come into 5 yards, but we've moved up to the top of this long ridge line that you can see here. The turkeys from down where we were at by the water hole have all come up onto here. What they're doing is coming up and then feeding up in this area right up in here on this plateau, so we're psyched that this might be the place. Bring it on. It's turkey taco time. We've been trying to use the strutter decoy, but it hasn't been working with these turkeys at this time of year for some reason. So we've gone ahead and just switched back to good old double, no, actually she's triple lucky, Tina turkey decoy. So we got her out there now. He came all the way from across that field, right to the decoy, and I was wide open. I mean, there was nothing I could do, and I finally had to lift the gun up, and when I moved, the call rolled off my lap, and that's what he heard. Let's go check. Let me put my shotgun down here. It's empty. Wow, wow, wow. Gould's turkey, a dream come true. This is unbelievable. Look at the beard on this. Nice one, huh? The legs on these things are unbelievable. And look at these tails, how long they are and how big they are. And beautiful, look at all the white. That's the part that I just love about these. In a way, they're kind of like the Miriams, where they've got the white on them, but these have got even more white all the way down here at the top of the behind here. What a beautiful fan on him. Isn't that something? Wow, up here in the mountains of Mexico, hunting turkeys in pine trees. We're about, I don't know, 4,500 foot elevation, something like that. Really good condition, an old gobbler. These are good spurs for here. Several of the birds that the other guys have shot didn't have any spurs at all. They don't get the big long hooks, these old ones. Wow. The other thing that's so great about this is this is the culmination of my slam of all the turkeys. Not just the North American ones, but the ones from Europe, South Pacific, all the ones in the US, and now this last one here in Mexico. This is a dream come true.
Hunting Gould's turkeys this early in the season, your best bet is to try and locate a single gobbler cruising the hills. I mean, he's out there trying to pick up chicks, right? As in turkey chicks? Anybody? Along the way, we're gonna try and capture, for the first time ever, a truly wild free-range Mexican Chihuahua dog.
Holy smokes, look at this right here. That's gotta be a Chihuahua footprint. There's a dog print right there, and it's little. I think this is a male by the size of the print. Look at this. Holy, they gotta be around here somewhere. They like these ridge lines like this, is what we've been told. Holy crap, there's one right there. There's one right there. Did you get that on film? Holy smokes!
Since we weren't able to catch one of the wild free-range dogs on camera, we decided to get back to our original task, which was killing a Gould's turkey.
Wow, what a change in the conditions. It's dropped to about 55 degrees in the middle of the afternoon. We've got rain clouds pouring in. We've got thunder and lightning. So who knows what this is going to do to the turkey hunt, but we're here, the turkey hunt. We're going to see. The good thing is it's making Tina, the tantalizing turkey decoy, dance all over the place. She looks like a ballerina out there, so.
Sitting in the rain was all worthwhile once I heard that turkey calling off to my right. He wasn't close, but it sounded like he was coming our way. It's a crazy setup when you've got turkeys calling around you, but they're behind you in the timber, and you can't see them, but you know from the sound of the call that they're getting closer and closer.
Well done, Tina. Woohoo! How about that? That is the goblinest turkey I've ever been around. That thing gobbled from about 300 yards over there, worked his way all the way in. He was sitting back here gobbling so hard, and I thought he was gonna come straight behind us. And there was a couple of hens that were putting behind us. And then eventually they came around exactly right, went up to the decoy. Woo! Man, I love turkey hunting. Gould's turkey. Look at that thing, huh? He's a little bit beat up. This is an old bird. And I didn't shoot him there. That's just beat up. Plus he's wet. They're not very pretty when they're wet. Unlike some other people I know. But he's got a good beard. He's got good spurs. Yep, for down here, that's good. Got a pretty decent beard on him. Here again, when it's all rainy, it doesn't come out that good, but good length. Right on. Another rugged expedition.